So in the next two lectures, I want to introduce spherical coordinates to you. We already did cylindrical coordinates, so that's the circle extended into the z direction, which is the cylinder shape. Now we're going to consider spherical coordinates, which is the geometry associated with a ball, right, with a sphere. So r is our position vector here. It has a length of r. And the other two coordinates is theta, the angle this position vector makes with the z axis, and then phi, which is the angle that the projection of this position vector onto the xy plane, the angle it makes with the x axis. So here we have x, y, z then, in spherical coordinates will be r, theta, and phi. Okay? The position vector can just be written as r, r hat. R hat is the direction of the position vector. So what is the transformation here? Well, we have x. So r sine theta projects onto the xy plane, and then cosine phi projects onto the x-axis. So this will be r sine theta cosine phi. Y, you project onto the xy plane, r sine theta, and then project onto the y-axis, which will be sine phi. And then z will be r, instead of sine theta, it will be r cosine theta. So projection onto the z-axis. Okay. So this gives us our change of variables formula. We also have the integral, the infinitesimal volume, dx, dy, dz. You can compute the 3 by 3 determinant of the Jacobian here, and you get r squared sine theta dr d theta d phi. So that's how you do the change of variables in spherical coordinates. Okay, now let's look at the unit vectors. Okay, so how do you write the unit vectors? The relationship between the unit vectors in spherical coordinates and the unit vectors in Cartesian coordinates. It's these rather complicated expressions. These are 3 by 3 matrices. If you know some matrix algebra, you can represent this as a matrix product. Then you can invert the matrix, and then you get I, j, k in terms of r hat, theta hat, and phi hat. So occasionally, these expressions need to be used. So I write them here. They're in the lecture notes. And you never, of course, you never memorize these things. These are things that you look up when they're needed. Okay, then in the next lecture, we're going to be talking about the differential operators. So in order to do that properly, we need to differentiate these unit vectors. Remember that the I, j, k vectors are fixed in space. Their derivatives are zero. But the r hat, theta hat, phi hat vectors depend on the angles. They depend on theta, and they depend on phi. So let's have a look to see if we compute the derivatives. Let's have a look to see what it looks like. Okay, so here are the derivatives of the unit vector. So again, r hat, theta hat, and phi hat depend on both theta and phi. So we need partial derivatives. So the partial derivative of r hat with respect to theta is theta hat. The partial derivative of theta hat with respect to theta is minus r hat. And the partial derivative of phi hat with respect to theta is 0. The partial derivative of r hat with respect to phi is sine theta phi hat. the partial derivative of theta hat with respect to phi is cosine theta phi hat, and the partial derivative of phi hat with respect to phi is minus sine theta r hat minus cosine theta hat. You can derive all of these from these expressions for the unit vectors. Okay, so in part A, I define what the spherical coordinate system is. Instead of x, y, z, we're using r, theta, phi. R is the length of your vector. Theta is the angle with the z-axis. Phi is the angle of the projection of the vector on the xy plane with the x-axis. This is the change of variables formula. This is how you do triple integrals. You transform dx, dy, dz to r squared sine theta, dr, d theta, d phi. R squared sine theta, then, is the determinant of the Jacobian. We also have the unit vectors, and we have the derivative of the spherical coordinate unit vectors. Everything's in the notes. When you need them to solve problems, typically, you look them up. It's very hard to remember these formulas. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.